You know, all throughout the week, I've kind of been coming back to this story of Trump's announcement on Monday that he was in fact taking hydroxychloroquine. And the reason I keep coming back to it is because there's so much information packed into that little press conference that it's taken a while to kind of uncover and digest. And what we've seen now, and this had previously kind of gone under the radar, but what he did Monday in that press conference was he literally declared science the enemy. Here is what Donald Trump said, and this was specifically when he was asked about the VA study that showed that people taking hydroxychloroquine while testing positive for COVID-19 actually have a higher rate of dying. This is what he said. He said, and if you look at the one survey, the only bad survey, they were giving it to people that were in very bad shape. They were very old, almost dead. The only negative I've heard was the study where they gave it, was it the Veterans Administration? With, you know, people that aren't big Trump fans gave it. He later went on to term the study a Trump enemy statement. So this study put out by the VA is a Trump enemy statement, is what the president called it. No, it's science. Science is not a Trump enemy statement. Science is science. Science is facts. Science is figures. Science is statistics. Although that's also a branch of math, but that's another discussion. Science is not pro-Trump or anti-Trump. Science is not Democrat or Republican. Science is not left, right, center, anything in between. Science just is. And we have to accept it. You can't fight that. You can try to challenge it through experimentation, through the scientific method. But even then, that's still science. Challenging science can be science. This man has launched a war on science since the day he came to the Oval Office. We have seen it at the EPA. We have seen it at other government agencies. We have seen it across the country with Republican-led states. And we're seeing it now with him literally declaring that a scientific study was a Trump enemy statement. Just because he didn't like the results of it, he automatically thinks that it is fake. And the one study that actually showed that, hey, this thing's showing some promise, after that came out, which I think was maybe March, other scientists started looking at this study and they determined that it was exceptionally flawed. This morning, shortly before sitting down here and recording videos for the day, a new study came out, a study of 90,000 people, about hydroxychloroquine and whether or not it was effective. And the answer is no. Other studies didn't even reach conclusions because they had to be stopped halfway through because too many people were dying. Most of the studies that have been done on this, good or bad, have not had a control group. They have not had a placebo. It has not been done the way a study normally would be done on any kind of pharmaceutical trial because people are trying to rush them. So the science, for the most part, has remained a little bit unclear, but it does err mostly on the side of this stuff is pretty dangerous and we don't know if it helps. But Trump is so hell-bent on trying to be right about this one thing that he's willing to dismiss the science. He's willing to say that these are Trump enemies at the Veterans Administration. And they just hate him. So I guess that's why they're killing veterans with hydroxychloroquine. Like, it makes no sense. Because this man makes no sense because nothing in his brain is working properly. But all of this underscores the larger point. There is no part of me that actually thinks this man has ever taken hydroxychloroquine at all. At all. I do not believe for a second he is on this medication. Nope. Didn't happen. A doctor, any doctor, would never give a patient a medication just because the patient asked for it for a condition which the patient doesn't even have. That's not how this works. That's not how the White House doctors work, and they're sure as hell not going to risk their entire medical career and reputation as being the doctor who prescribed an unnecessary, potentially fatal medication to the President of the United States and accidentally ended up killing them. That's how you end up with your name in a history book and not in a good way. And I don't care how much these doctors suck up to Trump, none of them want to be remembered for doing that.